I am Flash Isaac, and today I'll be taking you through the 10 laws to pass post UTME in any Nigerian university. After WAEC is JAMB, after JAMB is post UTME. That's if you wish to further and if you passed JAMB. So if you pass WAEC, you pass JAMB, post UTME should not be something that should draw you back or something that will make you regret. Like, I've tried though. No. Now that you're in post UTME level, you should pass. So now take a look at the 10 laws to pass post UTME. The first law is, thou shalt forget your JAMB score. Yes, if your JAMB score is too low, it may discourage you. You're like, my JAMB is not good. Are you sure I can pass post UTME? Then if your JAMB score is too high, it can make you overconfident. Like, I've passed the JAMB now. My JAMB score is high, so I must gain admission. In any of the two ways, they can still fall your hand. Yes, your school can still fall your hand full time. So those things, they are not factors. If your JAMB score is low, you can study very well, pass post UTME. If your JAMB score is very high, you can still study very hard in post UTME and overblast post UTME. Extreme score in post UTME and extreme score in JAMB is equals first badge admission. You are good to go. Chicken now? Good. Now the second law is revive your appetite. After reading for WAEC, reading for JAMB, you've read, so you tend to get tired. You get tired of reading because you've read a lot of books. You'll be like, what would I read again? I'm tired. Forget those ones. Revive your appetite. Get your materials back, your books, the things you need, and boost your reading again. Start reading. Start to work. Read as if you've not read for WAEC, or read as if you didn't read for WAEC, as if you didn't read for JAMB. Start a fresh reading. Start a ginger. The third law is, thou shalt have the mentality that there is no time. Live your life with sense of urgency. The truth is, so long everything is working fine in the country, after JAMB, post UTME is very close. And once your school releases post UTME form, it is 2 weeks to the exam. So schools release post UTME 2 to 3 weeks to the exam. So when the form is out, before you start registering, running around, exam is already there. So immediately after JAMB, have it in mind that the next thing is post UTME. Post UTME is tomorrow. Post UTME is tomorrow. This will help you to read, study, so that you just do these things once and for all and move on with your life. Thou shalt remember. Don't read to forget. Read to remember. Read, reread, and understand. Remember what you've read. Don't forget things. If you think you are forgetting anything, go back to the topic and read. Make sure you remember everything, because post UTME tests your ability to remember what you've read. And if you've read a lot, when it's close to the exam and you see some kind of question and their answer, since the exam is extremely close, then you have to cram. Yes, cramming is bad generally, but when necessary, cram some things. The fifth law, thou shalt speed up without calculator. One of the most important requirements in post UTME is speed. In post UTME, in any school, you don't have time. So post UTME tests your speed. In fact, of all the exams I've seen, even while you are in school, nothing tests your speed like post UTME. In school exam, university exam, you even have time. In WAEC, you have a little some time. But in post UTME, you don't have time. I remember writing UTME post UTME years ago. I wrote about 90 questions in less than 1 hour. And you see BB calculation questions. And to add salt to injury, they don't give you a calculator. So just imagine me solving bearing questions, simultaneous equation question, matrices with big values, no calculator practice. So before I solve without calculator, improve your speed. Begin to solve question in seconds. You don't have time. Thou shalt follow my videos. So I have videos covering your post UTME subject. So search Flash Learners on YouTube or visit flashlearners.com. You see all my videos. Go through the videos. I've explained all the subjects and topics. Follow them, and it will be very easy for you, and you'll be fine. 8. Thou shalt not be too proud to forget WAEC and JAMB questions. Post UTME is nothing special. It's still your O-level. It tests. So your WAEC and JAMB questions are still very important. Pick them and answer. Look for questions anywhere and solve. Just be solving. That is the law of post UTME. You may not even need to even read too much. Read, solve. 40% reading, 60% solving, 40% reading, 60% calculations, 60% questions and answers. Law 9, thou shalt test yourself. You've read, fine. Do you really know what you've read? Do you think you can still remember? Go reading through the textbook, you feel I've read this thing and know it. Test yourself whether you really know it. Set, for your school's position, me, bring out a particular year, close everywhere, shut the internet, and solve. See how many you can remember. See whether you can really solve it. Remember, you don't know it until it is proven. You don't know it until you've tested yourself. If you cannot solve it 5 times straight without spying, then you don't know it. Test yourself. The 10th law. Thou shalt read for long hours. Yes, you need time to read. It's not 5 minutes or 10 minutes reading. So thou shalt read for long hours. Read your book, study. It's not long. Just pay that price within that short time and life becomes better for you. Alright, thanks for watching. Feel free to check out my other videos and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.